A very very good evening to all of you, my dear kids. I am Manisha Das on behalf of Etishan family. Welcome you all to today's class. Let me remind you that our Etishan family is providing quality education for your better tomorrow. So don't forget to be a part of our family. So my dear class 9 students, today we are at the part 4 of our lesson, Diversity in Living Organisms. And in today's part, we are going to discuss about Kingdom Animalia. So by its name you can recognize, right? So today we are going to study about animals, right? There are different types of animals we are seeing around us. So how they are divided into different phylums or different groups? So in today's part we are going to discuss. So let's move ahead to today's class. So what are the points we are going to discuss today? In today's part we will be discussing about animalia. It means specially about animals and different type of phylums. It means different type of groups they are put and their characteristics and examples. So my dear kids, animalia, these are organisms which are eukaryotic, multicellular and heterotrophic. Okay, plants are autotrophic because they can make their own food. But these animals are eukaryotes, okay, and multicellular, they have more than one cell, and they are heterotrophic. It means they cannot make their own food. They depend on others for their food. Then their cells do not have cell walls. They do not have their cell walls. And most animals are mobile. Mobile means they can move from one place to another. They are movable. They can move, not this one mobile, right? So, now next is, they are further classified based on the type of the body design differentiation found. So, they are put into certain groups as I told you, and they are put into groups on the basis of their body design. How their body is designed according to that, they are put into different groups. So, see this funny monkey, it's showing you its tongue, right? It's teasing us. So there are different types of organisms we see around us and they are put into different groups, okay? So in today's class, we will be discussing about them. So see, this is our kingdom Animalia. Again, further it is divided into sub-kingdoms that are Protozoa and Eumetazoa. And Protozoa, again it is divided into phylum, that is Protozoa. It is in your book, phylums are given in your book. Protozoa, phylum Porifera, Cnidaria and Ctenophora, see it's silent here. The next one are Platyhelminthes, Nematohelminthes and Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusk and Echinodermata and Chordata. Okay, about them we are going to discuss in lot of details. Okay, these are so many things are given in this picture. Just ignore it. We have to only remember about this phylum. Protozoa, Porifera, Cnidaria, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata and Chordata. Okay. So let's move ahead. First one is Porifera. Have you seen this cartoon SpongeBob? Right? So it's basically a sponge, right? SpongeBob is a sponge. So the word Porifera means organisms with holes. So you have seen in SpongeBob's body, there are lots of holes. It means it's a sponge. It is having lot of holes. So in this group, we have put such organisms which have many holes. These are non-motile animals attached to some solid support. You can see in this picture they are attached with rocks and other solid support. They cannot move. SpongeBob is moving, but in actual sponges don't move. And there are holes or pores all over their body. There are so many holes in their body. This leads to a canal cavity that helps in circulating water throughout the body to bring in food and oxygen. So by this type of body structure, it's very easy for them to get water, food and oxygen. These animals are covered with a hard outside layer or skeleton, and from the outside it is covered by it's have a protective covering. The body design involves very minimal differentiation. It means they do not have a well developed differentiation of body parts, right? And they are commonly called as sponges. They are called as sponges and are mainly found in marine habitat. It means they are found in seas and oceans. SpongeBob also live inside the sea, right? Yes. Now moving to the next, Collentrata, that is Cnidaria. Okay. So these are animals living in water. They are found in water. They show more body design differentiation. It means as compared to Yes, as compared to the sponges, they show more differentiation. There is a cavity in the body. Their body has a cavity, and the body is made up of two layers of cell. It means their body is made up of two layers of cell and one makeup cells on the outside. It means one outside layer, one inner side layer. Some of these species live in colonies. So some of them live in a group. Okay, they are called as corals. While others have a solitary lifespan, this is called hydra. Okay, they divide from their body, they make different organisms. And jellyfish and sea anemones are also common examples, right? Okay. Now, what are platyhelminthes? Platyhelminthes, you just remember that the body is bilaterally symmetrical. Bi means two. Their symmetrical means if I will cut them in half, in the middle portion, they will be similar in both the part. In the left side and right side, both are same. There are three layers of cell. Okay, they have three layers of cell. That's why they are called as triploblastic. They have three layers of cell which differentiated tissues can be made. So three layers of cell, they make three different types of tissues, which that's why they are called as triploblastic. This allows outside and inside body linings as well as some organs to be made. So these different types of layer of cell make them outside and inside body linings along with some organs, right? And there is thus some degree of tissue formation. They have different types of tissues, and there is no true internal body cavity or coelom in which well-developed organ can be accommodated. Well-developed organs are not there. You can see like that, they're very simple structure, right? And the body is flat, dorsoventral. It means they're flat structures, right? So mainly flat worms are included. So they are either free living or parasitic. For example, free living animals like planaria, okay, they are free. And parasitic like liver flukes, they are harmful for us. That's why they are called as parasitic, okay. Now next is nematoda. Nematoda body is also bilaterally symmetric and triploblastic. Three layers, and right side and left side are equal, symmetrical. However, the body is cylindrical rather than flattened. Okay, so their body is not flat, okay, and their body is like cylinder like structure. There are tissues but no real organs. They have tissues but no real organs. All the sort of body cavity or a pseudo coelom is present. Body cavity is there, pseudo, false one. And these are very similar as parasitic worms causing disease. You can see these are parasitic worms. They cause disease in our body, such as the worms causing elephantiasis is filarial worm, which causes filariasis. And the worms in the intestine, roundworm or pinworm, okay, they also cause so many diseases in our body. Next is annelida. Okay, you. Annelid animals are also bilaterally symmetrical. They are also bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic. It means three layers of cell. But in addition, they have a true body cavity. Their cavity, the body have a true cavity. It means they have true organs which is inside their body structure. And there is thus extensive organ differentiation inside their body. Different organs are also there. Wait a minute. So this differentiation occurs in segmental. Have you seen earthworm? And you can see here in this fluke, you can see leech. This is a leech, right? Then see, it is had different segments. Okay, it has different segments lined up. And these animals are also found in variety of habitats. It can be found in fresh water, marine water, and also in the land. Earthworms and leeches, these are earthworms, right? They have segmented body. And this is a leech which suck blood from humans and animals, right? It has also segmented body. I don't feel good looking at them actually. Next is arthropoda. So this is probably the largest group. Arthropoda, okay, they have a diverse different types of organisms. So many organisms are there. Okay, it is the largest group of animals. These animals are bilaterally symmetrical. It means both the sides, they are symmetrical. And segmented, they have segmented body. You can look here, all of them are segmented body. And there is an open circulatory system, and so the blood does not flow in well-defined blood vessels. So these do not have a they have open circulatory system. They do not have blood vessels, right? And the coelomic cavity is blood filled and they have jointed legs. You can look here, they have jointed legs. Arthropod means jointed legs. They all have jointed legs. And some familiar examples are prawns here, butterflies, house flies, spiders, scorpions and crabs. So they are arthropods, they have jointed legs. Next is mollusca. Who are they? Yes, in the animals of this group, they are also biologically symmetrical and the coelomy cavity is reduced. There is a little segmentation. Segmentation is there but very little. And they have an open circulatory system and kidney-like organs for excretion. They have excretory organs. So, literally they are developing, right? So, there is a foot that is used for moving around. So, some of them have foot. And examples are snail, mussels. So, they have octopus also. It comes under them. Next is protocodata. Who are they? These animals are bilaterally symmetrical. They are also equal, right side, left side, both are symmetrical. They are triploblastic, having three layers and have a coelom. In addition, they show a new feature of body design, namely a notochord, at least at some stages during their lives. They have a notochord. Notochord means string-like structure. It is their long rod-like support structure, string-like structure that run along the back of the animal, separating the nervous. You can see one cord, okay? This cord is running throughout the body, separating the nervous tissues from the gut. Next is, it provides a place for muscles to attach. It means the cord is there and with the cord the muscles will get attached for easy movement. And protocodates may not have a proper notochord present at all stages in their life. In all stages they do not have, but when they grow at certain stage they have these cords. And for the entire length of the animal. Now protocodates are marine general. They are found in water. Examples are Balanoglossus, Hadmanian and Amphioxus. Next are Echinodermata. Echinodermata means spiny animals. It means animals those who are having spines. So in Greek, echino means hedgehog, which have spines. Like kanta laga, it means in their body they have kanta. Right, spines. So derma means skin. Echinodermata, it means kante wale animals. Okay, now next is, thus these are spiny skinned organisms. Next, these are exclusively they are found in marine life. They are triploblastic, three layers of skin, and have a coelom cavity, open cavity. Then they also have a peculiar water driven tube system. Because they are found in water, they use for moving around. So they have hard calcium carbonate structure that used as a skeleton. Okay, they have a skeleton. Example, sea star, sea urchins, like that. Now vertebrates. These animals have a true vertebral column and internal skeleton, allowing a completely different distribution of muscle attachment points. Like us, like vertebrates are having true skeletal system, like us, we are also included in this group, vertebrate. So vertebrates are bilaterally symmetrical. If we'll cut them, they will be bilaterally symmetrical. And they are also, yes, they are also triploblastic. It means having three layers of cell, coelomic and segmented. Our body is also segmented with complex differentiation of body tissues and all, because we are most developed, right? And we have body tissues and organs differentiation. All chordates possess the following features. What are the features? Have an notochord? Yes, we have. Have a dorsal nerve cord? Yes, we have. Triploblastic, three layers. Have paired gill pouches, right? We have. Gill pouch means lungs, we have. And are coelomate, we have coeloms. And vertebrates are grouped into six classes, about which we'll be discussing in our next part. Their vertebrates are, it means there are lots of animals, right? So in vertebrates, again we have divided them into certain groups, like birds, fishes, snakes, like that. We have differentiated into different groups, so about which we will be discussing in our later classes. Okay, so my dear kids, animals have hearts that feel, eyes that see, and families to care for, just like you and me. As if we are saying that you told me this or you scolded me, I'm feeling very sad. Okay, so also when I feel sad, I used to cry. Okay, and I have so many responsibilities like that. Animals also have the same. The difference is that they cannot express, they cannot say to us, or we cannot understand. But they do have all these things just like you and me. So never hurt them, right? Always help them. So at last, I would like to request to be a part of our e-tuition family. Do watch, like, share and subscribe to our channel. Till then, stay safe, stay happy. Goodbye.